Welcome everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week I've got an Affinity photo iPad tutorial for you, but all the methods that we're using today can be used on the desktop version as well. And today we're going to do some blending. So we've got two photos here. We've got a photo of a dog and a photo of a bird. And we're going to blend in the dog into the bird and create a bird dog. So should be a little bit of fun. So let's start off in our selections persona, which is up the top here, the selections persona. Let's make the picture a little bit bigger by using our fingers to drag it around, clicking on our selection brush here, and I've got my brush set to about 1920. And let's make a selection of the head of the dog all the way around, and we just basically want the dog's head here, and make the brush a little bit smaller. I just want some of the dog's neck as well, just where that color is there, down to about there. Looks pretty good. Let's click on our refine and let's fix up any areas we think we might need to go over again. That all looks pretty good. A couple of little areas. Let's click on the little arrow down here and come to feather. Let's feather it by 4. Click on smooth and smooth by 4 as well. And on our selection output, we want selection new layer. And hit apply, and that's put the head of the dog on its own layer here. Let's come over to our photo persona now and click on our move tool. Let's position the head of the dog where we think it's going to look the best. And a good little tip, if you come up here to layer options, we can drop the opacity a little bit just so we can see through, see where we want to position the dog here. Thinking looking pretty good, just about there. Okay, the next thing we want to do on the layer of the dog is add a layer mask, or hit our plus here and click on mask layer, and that will give us a mask on the dog's head layer here. We're going to grab our paintbrush tool. We're going to make sure we've got a nice soft brush. We're also going to make sure that we're painting in black and we're still on the mask layer. We're going to grab our flow here and we're going to change it to 10. We're going to keep our opacity at 100, and we can use the width here to make our brush bigger and smaller. So I'm going to make my brush a little bit bigger. I'm going to zoom in now. I'm using two fingers to zoom in and make my brush a little bit smaller. And we're just going to start blending with our pencil here, or your finger if you haven't got a Apple Pencil. Just start blending that area in. Just nice easy strokes on up and down to get that nice blend. And then I'm going to drop my flow to 5 and maybe my brush a little bit bigger. And I'm going to start blending that in a little bit more up here. Just blending that in nice and easy. Okay, that looks pretty good. The next thing we're going to do is add a new pixel layer. So we're going to come up here to the plus and pick pixel layer. We're going to come over here to our layer options, and we're going to change the blend mode to color, and we're going to pick color. So that's the blend mode on color. Let's go back to our layers. So we've got our pixel layer. The blend mode is on color. Still on our paintbrush tool here. Still on a nice soft brush. Going to change our flow to about 15, keeping our opacity at 100 and our hardness at 0. Clicking on our color here, we're going to grab our color picker and come down all the way to about the middle of the bird's chest here and just pick that color. Click on the color to activate it. Back to our layers, make sure we're on that pixel layer with the blend mode color. Got our paintbrush, we've got our new color down here. I'm going to have my flow at 15, and wherever you see all these little red areas on the dog, we're just going to paint over now, and we're going to change the color to the sort of same color. All those red areas, let's just paint over. There we go, make sure we don't miss any. We're also going to do the eyes and the little bits above the eyes and the ears as well. So let's get all that red, changing those colors. Make sure we don't miss anything. A little bit under the nose here, down the bottom here as well. Okay, let's zoom out. Let's click back on the head layer here. I'm just going to grab my move tool because I can see that I've still got a bit of the bird on the side there. So I'm just going to move that out a tiny little bit, and that's looking pretty good. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do on the head layer here, I'm going to come to my filters and I'm going to add a depth of field filter. But make sure you're on the layer with the head of the dog. Just going to make this a little bit smaller, move it into the middle. I want most of the dog's face to be in focus, but maybe some of the ears we're just going to fade a little bit into the background. So on my radius here, going to go about 20. That's a little bit too much, so I'm going to dial that back a little bit to about, let's do it about 10 and hit apply. So that's looking pretty good there. So we've got those ears just fading into the background and the face of the dog in focus. Okay, that is looking pretty good. So there we go, everybody. That's blending two objects together in Affinity Photo. We've taken the bird and added the head of the dog, added a bit of depth of field, and done some little color changes on the dog's head. So I hope you've enjoyed this short iPad tutorial. If you did, please consider subscribing to my channel. Please give me a thumbs up, and until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.